Well, for more on what's happening between Uber and Waymo and how driverless technology is developing as a whole, we're joined by Scott Schober, President and CEO of Berkeley Varitronic Systems. Welcome back to the show.
Yeah, thanks for having me back.
So let's start with this Waymo Uber lawsuit. For people who aren't aware of what's happening with this, especially with its autonomous vehicles, what's at stake here?
Oh, this is huge for the automobile industry and for innovative technology. This is incredible. There are 44 some active companies now developing autonomous vehicles, these self-driving vehicles. This is really the wave of the future, and huge, huge investments, billions of dollars, the automakers and other synergistic companies are making in this. So to win or fail here could make or break many of these large companies. So it's certainly a battle in this case between Waymo, which is the parent of or the parents Alphabet and Google, of course, which are a big backer, versus that of Uber, which a ride-sharing service which we're all very familiar with and many people now use actively around the globe.
So with so many of these tech firms and car firms acquiring talent and buying up some of these startups, can we expect more lawsuits like this then?
Yeah, certainly. And if you look at Uber, a company, again, that we all are very familiar with, they've had a really rough path. If you think about it, they have had lawsuit after lawsuit, sexual harassment. They've had some pricing issues. And now this comes about with losing really a key player is something that's very dangerous, because here there's possible compromise of IP. As you mentioned, 14,000 documents. And really the IP in this case, the heart of all of these autonomous driving cars is really the LiDAR, and that's a laser, a 3D laser that allows them to image and look all around so they don't crash into other things. That could be a couple thousand dollars to $10,000 per vehicle. Perfecting that technology is the key. Whoever can get there first will be successful in this race for sure.
Now, speaking of this race, a lot of people are wondering, when can we actually expect these autonomous cars to finally get into the hands of consumers, or at least be available for commercial use?
Well, it certainly won't be tomorrow. That's a great question. Probably in the neighborhood of 5 to 7 years, and you see more and more people and the technology advancing rapidly. The key is getting trials. Certainly with Alphabet and Waymo, they're working now with Fiat and Chrysler. They've partnered with them. They've got trials, 500 plus vehicles, minivans that are out there now in Arizona. And that's key to trial this and pilot it, get the kinks worked out, will allow for the early adopters to get there much quicker. You look at a company that's got the backing of Alphabet, Google, they're $680 billion market cap, only second to that of Apple, who's about $800 billion currently. So there's a lot of money behind this, and they want this to succeed. Plus, they've got a lot of other successful divisions and companies that they keep acquiring. So very good chance that they'll be the lead in this development, I think, and probably first to market, even before the likes of Uber and Lyft and others that are investing heavily in this technology.
And Scott, obviously this is a global race to try and get these cars on the road first. Which countries and companies, you tapped on some of the companies, but what about some of the countries that are in the best position to really get there first?
Well, there's going to be some others. Look at China, you know, Baidu, heavily invested in there. All the major automotive companies, Audi, BMW, Ford, again, they've got a global presence there. But certainly within the United States, there's a huge outpouring of investment. There's probably upwards of $50 to $100 billion that it's planning VC companies to invest in a lot of these startup technology companies that are honing in on autonomous vehicles, these self-driving cars. So the next couple of years are going to be extremely exciting, where we are today versus who's going to get there to market first.
And it'll be exciting, but it may also be challenging. Let's look at some of the issues that we're seeing with things like security and trying to prevent hackers from accessing these vehicles. How big of a concern is that?
Oh, it's a huge concern. And that's an area I've been watching very closely. If you look at just even the 3D lasers, the LiDAR that's on top of these vehicles, what happens, one would ask, if somebody took another laser there and shined it at it, or tried to hack in through some of the wireless sensors of the vehicle, which has been proven in other manufacturers of vehicles. Huge concern there. So they have to really think security early on to prevent being a victim of hacks in the next 5 to 10 years.
And how are lawmakers preparing for this?
Well, they're usually following a little bit too far behind. They got to step it up here. put laws in place, and the public has to be comfortable with it at the same time. They're going to be looking, the public, what are safety concerns? What if the system gets confused and the car goes off the road or life is lost? There's already been a couple accidents that have been reported on. So the legalities and the risks are very high. They got to be very careful with the testing stage, which most companies are at right now. Put those pilots out there in rural areas, get all the kinks out so they could make it much safer.
All right, thank you. We appreciate your insight. Scott Schober, President and CEO at Berkeley Varitronic Systems.